started. My name is Anatol, and I'm talking about portability with focus on PHP. Here's just a bit about me. Is that looking good?
Yep.
Yeah. Okay. So you can reach me later for questions. I'm working with Microsoft at OSTC. We have a team of four people working like on stability on Windows, PHP stability on Windows. Here are just some other projects which communicate with open source or contribute to open source, integrate projects into commercial products. And one small deviation I planned, because PHP 7 was supposed to be out. But anyway. Exactly, so still it's gonna be a short wait period, time period to see the general availability. Now to the actual topic, interoperability, and how I would define it. First, there is an array of hardware in the world, and that hardware sometimes is put together, like there can be toaster or computer, but anyway, that's a hardware constellation, and upon that there is an operating system which supports that hardware. So these three components is what I would call a platform, and then there is a program, a tiny little program like PHP, which wants to run on as many platforms as possible. So with PHP, there is actually yet another level on that, because PHP is a programming language, and we want that our scripts are also portable. And these are topics I plan to touch today. Maybe I will not have time to touch all of them, but I think the 64-bit and the thread safety are the interesting ones regarding PHP 7. I include details for internals and for like normal PHP programming, so that's why my question is, who in this audience did not program internals? Because okay, that's good. So I guess I will skip like a file system, because it's actually so I will then do more accent on the internal part, PHP. But anyway, some parts of user space are included anyway. Okay.
Isn't the file system though a big portability problem?
At the very low level, it's quite some difference. Sorry?
Unicode versus ASCII.
Yeah, and permissions, so file permissions, process permissions, all that stuff. That's what PHP provides with a good abstraction level. And I would skip it. So because we have more time for the other topics. Just a small introduction here. With differences between, there are actually differences between same Linux and Unix families, but not that big than Linux Unix, Linux Windows, so Unix Linux Windows, we use GCC to compile, because PHP is written in C as interpreter, we compile it with GCC on Linux, and we compile it with Visual C on Windows. PHP can also be compiled with other compilers like Clang or Intel Composer, but the good way to get a production binary is to have GCC or Visual C. Also, approach on Unix Linux is to have many libraries, like there are libraries with various functionality, and there is a they can communicate with kernel with the standard C library, but actually these are like encapsulated pieces of functionality, and there is it is the same on Windows, but we use many open source libraries to work to build PHP binaries for Windows. But there are also there is also the system API on Windows, which is not open source, and we have to use it in quite some situations to exploit the operating system functionality. Now, another approach is like Unix philosophy tells us one task, one process. This is almost the case on Linux, and on Windows programs tend to be threaded. Now, I'm going to explain the difference between process and threads a bit later. Now, PHP interpreter is written in C, and it sticks to C89 standard, but GCC compiles by default C99. Visual C supports C99 as well. We built PHP 7 with Visual Studio 2015, which claims to support C99 completely. Still, PHP is C89, not always, but still. So the differences, that's what I'm skipping, is the differences in file system and permissions, so we can have more internal details here. So I'm going straight ahead to Time API, if it wants to.
Exactly.
And Time API is actually a fragile topic. We have from time to time some bug reports about timings in PHP, but the bugs are often not fixable in PHP. So, and it starts with the hardware. There is always a hardware source first, hardware time source, like TSC timestamp counter. It's a processor register which delivers events at some frequency. Another hardware source could be a power management device. Another hardware time source could be a multimedia chip, like in modern in gamers' computers. So maybe there are other time sources. Actually, the operating system will choose one of them, the best one. Of course, any of those hardware sources can have bugs, and upon that, there are software APIs. Those, like what I'm listing here, POSIX clock, it's not used in PHP, but it's just like a specification to implement time interfaces. And another one, the API before Windows 8 and after Windows 8 with differences in time precision. So in PHP, we use most extensively the get time of day, which is like standard C library functionality on Linux, and which is a custom implementation on Windows. Actually, on any platform, the get time of day is a wall clock, and it can be influenced by some user space tools like NTP, so network time protocol, or network synchronization. So actually, this can lead to quite some fun bugs, like micro time before is bigger than micro time after, or in conjunction with you sleep in conjunction with timeout handling. It's here is an interesting bit of user code. So in on Linux, the script timeout is handled in the same process, and on Windows, the script timeout is handled in a separate thread. So that means the usleep call will freeze all the whole process. And actually, on Linux, we can have like we have to adjust our script sleep time according to this to the actual to how long it did actually sleep. But also, regarding sleep itself, there is no guarantee that it will sleep as long as you want. Like There can be a situation where you want it to sleep one microsecond, but it will sleep 3 microseconds, and so on. So it's not really not that reliable as it looks like, and it's not a PHP's fault anyway. Performance, here I would probably skip this one, and who was not in Pierre's talk? Yeah, okay, so because you can check with Pierre's talk, it is about how to make your PHP a portable way, how to speed up PHP in a portable way, even PHP 5, even bottlenecks. So if you was in Pierre's talk, you have this information in 30 minutes, not in one slide. And otherwise, you can come to me and ask therapist later. And this, the next one is actually much more interesting. So if we don't touch assembler and compiler intrinsics in PHP, which are used actually in PHP at some points, but with assembler it can bring speed up, but it's not maintainable a good way. And intrinsics could be actually good, but it would be better try to avoid them. But for those who embarrass themselves to compile PHP by hand, it's PGO is or FDO, like a profile guided optimization with Visual C, and feedback directed optimization with GCC. It's actually a quite similar technology, or quite same. So I'm explaining it with using PGO. First you produce a build, a special build that can be trained, then you run use cases against it, use cases for your application, like, and the last step, you rebuild that binary using the all the training information. Then the binary is optimized for exactly the use cases you used to train. So that means you can get a binary which is dedicated to one exact application. Other applications could be slower, and but to run just one application, it's a good way to get a speed up for free, or almost for free. Here are just comments for that. On Windows, it's used, PGO is used starting with PHP 5.4, if I recall correctly, and we now have FDO with PHP 7 available. So this is a good way and cheap way to speed up PHP for one application. 64-bit, it's a big topic in PHP 7, for me anyway, because and for Windows users, because 64 bits are now consistent over all the platforms. But first, who wants to ask, is there anyone who would like to answer this question?
I mean, does it work? It does something.
It does something. Yeah, what exactly?
In PHP so 5 there are or actually. PHP 7.
Sorry?
In PHP 5 or PHP 7?
Good point, exactly. So, PHP 5 or PHP 7, 64 bit or 32 bit, and 64-bit operating system or 32-bit operating system. So there are quite some quite some combinations which will make like 6 to the power of, number of combinations. Okay, let's talk about that. So in general, yeah, just to explain it. 32-bit or 64-bit, it's here. So on 32-bit, a process can handle only 2 GB of memory. That means the deprivos snippet given you would enable the memory limit to max. It would eat up the process memory, and then something bad would happen. If the operating system is 32-bit as well, then it, something bad would happen to the operating system if it doesn't swap or swap or not. So this is basically a software limit on that. And what we have on 64-bit build and operating system will be pretty much the same, but you see that you see how much memory actually a 64-bit build of PHP can handle. And in PHP 7, that means also for the strings. Strings can be also as long as the amount of memory you have. So there is actually no such hardware system which can hold that amount of RAM. And maybe there is one which is at CIA, but I don't work with CIA, so I don't know. And that means actually on 64-bit, it will eat up all the memory as well, but it's not the software limit, but hardware limit. That means 64-bit systems are can still not exhaust the hardware we have today. Exactly. So.
And this for different users too. We mentioned before that for this part, even with the 64-bit builds of PHP on Windows and some other platform that is mostly not used for web servers anyway on Linux, but you don't have actually 64-bit integers even if you do a 64-bit build. So you won't have access to all the 64-bit information even if you do a 64-bit build because of the way it was done in PHP 5 and so on.
Yeah, exactly. That's what I was going to say it because it's a good news for user for Windows user for one that it's consistent over all the platforms with native 64-bit integers with file operations with anything else, and the strings in PHP 7 can be indefinitely long. So that means we can read big amounts of memory, big amounts. Of data into memory and processing is there. Now, there are opinions that it's not useful for the today's web development, for everyday's web development. It could be, actually it will be useful for console scripts, for cron jobs and things like that anyway. So that's it. And for those who don't program, it's probably not useful, and for those who program in terminals, these are the some of portable data types that are used in PHP 7, and this is the list of the functions that is that are now consistent across all the platforms, including Windows. So the next one.
3 minutes.
Okay. because we had that hardware issue. Yeah. So then just a quick because thread safety is also a portability issue. Namely, just to define what is a process. Process is like if you have a binary file on a hard drive, then you click on it on invoke on console, then operating system will start it, and then we'll look for some particular address in the memory and execute it. So it will cause an execution flow in on one core. This is a single-threaded process, and the multi-threaded process is something similar, but there are multiple instruction flows executed within the same process. Now, why I talk about this is because there is Because PHP supports thread safety, and because so I skipped some slides because we are too late now. Because PHP supports thread safety, and because there are web servers that support thread safety, and there are quite some functions that can be affected. Like for example, symlink. It's one of classic examples. It's not thread safe in the C runtime, and that means as soon as you use a relative path with that, it can be that in one thread you are about to create a symlink. Then in another thread you change the current working gear, and suddenly you create a symlink to wrong target, or it fails because the source doesn't exist, and so on. So there are quite some portability issues, and they are also to be cared about when developing PHP scripts. Here is just a list of functions that PHP core team developed to keep PHP portable across the platforms. Like on some platforms, some functions can be missing or can behave differently, and we have all such cases inside the core, and that's how much we care about the portability. Now, we have no time for questions, fortunately. So thank you very much for attending, and have a great experience.